just up in front, as I go through these lights, is the college. They've actually got a college now for the RNLI. If anybody doesn't know what that means, it's Royal National Lifeboat Institution. They're quite a big organization. As I previously said in the annotations, this is their head office, their headquarters at Poole for the whole country. So we're just doing a quick little dive into our railway bus lay-by. That'll be straight out again, no doubt. We've got Asda. I don't know what that building is. I think that is Asda there. Or is it? Yeah, I think it is. What a place. Yes, it is. What a place to stick a store. You can't see it, unfortunately, but just past the Asda is water that's called Holes Bay, and all the lifeboats that are down for repair, refitting, what have you, plus the ones that are resident, are all parked around there. It would have been nice to have gone and seen them, but that wasn't on my venue for today. My venue was to come down and do my chat number 25. I actually put it down to 26, it's 25. But it was such a convoluted process, and I had so much trouble trying to upload the original file. It wouldn't actually load. It gave me an awful lot of bother because it was just ridiculous. The file was so big, it just wouldn't. It stopped, actually. Uploaded the first small part and then completely stopped, so I had to do it all over again and chop the big file up into little bits. That's why it's in little sections now, and there was a lot more of it as well, but I've chopped it down to a reasonable size. It's given you the full journey down here to Poole anyway. I'll do the commentary all the way through now because there is music playing, and I'm knowing how finicky YouTube is about copyright and stuff, I would prefer not to get a strike at this juncture. I'm not overly bothered about it, but so far so good. I've got a clean channel at the moment. As far as copyright strikes go, I'd like to keep it that way if possible. Just going up over Town Bridge now, Towngate Bridge. That large round circular shaped building, well, two of them, is the actual headquarters of Barclays Bank down here. That's their main offices. I used to deliver to them years and years ago. They've got an underground basement where I always had to drive into. So we're just coming up to the center of Poole now. If not the actual geographical centre, it certainly is the commercial centre of Poole. I've got to get round this roundabout and then do battle with the weird road system they've got due to this idiotic COVID nonsense. I've never seen anything so ridiculous in my life. The buses have got to disgorge their passengers outside the bus station. They've got part of the road coned off, as you're going to see right now on the left. It's just diabolical, it's ridiculous. So the bus is just parked there. You've got to go use the bus lane to get past them. I don't have any problem with that anyway, but cars have got to do that as well. Past the theatre in Poole, I can't remember what it's called now, but it's very nice in there. Then we turn and left at this roundabout up here, sell down roundabout. Then on to the next one, which is not too far from the back of the Poole Hospital. Quite a large hospital as far as they go. Although Bournemouth's, I think, is quite a bit bigger. I'm not 100% sure. I think Bournemouth would be bigger. But in any case, it matters not. We've got Poole Park on the right hand side of us in a moment. I'll show you where that is when we actually get to it. It's just over this roundabout on the right-hand side, which is where Poole Park is situated. It's a very nice park, actually. They've even got a small narrow gauge railway in there. I don't know what it's running at the moment with all this COVID shite going on, but it is nice. It's a nice little railway, which if I had anything to do with it, I'd run around the whole park and give people a really good long ride. So you've got a little mini golf course thing here on the right, which I've got absolutely no interest in whatsoever, but for people that like that sort of thing, yep. There's tennis courts down here, and as I said, on the right, there is a big boating lake. It is quite a big lake. You can lots of people jog around it as a way of exercising. A lot of people use it, and they've also got exercise points. I can't think what they're called now, but you've got all these. I can't think of the word, but you've got all these contraptions. You can do press ups and all sorts of weird stuff. I tried it once, it almost killed me. There's a cafe, there's toilets, they're probably locked because of this nonsense, but it is quite a decent park. It's well worth a visit, actually, just to see the park. So, yeah, this is Poole Civic Centre. Straight in front of us, the big white building is like the town hall, I would imagine it's called the town hall, I'm not sure. But there's several buildings. There used to be the police station there as well, so it's called the Civic Centre. The unemployment benefit office is there, or was there. I know that for a fact because I used to have to go down there occasionally. It's all been chopped and changed about. Unbelievable that they do, they just chop and change these towns about so they're unrecognizable virtually. Anyway, you've got three lanes of traffic ahead, which this has always been a nightmare getting into the centre lane because there's no sort of lead off into it. You just got to cross over and hope nobody sideswipes you. Like this little black car eventually is going to cut in front of me. She's in the right-hand lane. I'm in the correct lane for where I want to go. Here she goes. She's just going to cut in front of me now. There she goes, clever little girl. So, I didn't beep at her or anything like that. I don't get too upset about things like that. It's annoying, but hey, we all do things that annoy people, I suppose. So around the other side of the Civic Centre, you can see they're actually rebuilding or knocking down. I don't know what the hell they're doing there. They got the hoardings round. But that white flattish build, flat roof building, yes, that's been there for a lot, for quite some time. Now we're heading towards Sandbanks. We go under the railway again, but this is the main line, the Waterloo to Weymouth line. It's a short tunnel underneath of it. The actual line is on quite a stiff gradient. It's quite a climb to get up to Branksome, which is up on the left-hand side. You won't see Branksome from here, but it's about a mile away, I suppose. So yeah, here's the railway arch. This guy coming on the other side, I think he was a little bit fed up because he's been there for a little while. Hey, you've got to give way. There's no way you can get two vehicles passing in there. It's too tight. But he looked a little bit fed up when I came through. But hey, too bad. I've had to wait in queues. It won't hurt him to wait for a few seconds. He's not going to die. And you will see as we head down this road. They start a bike lane. They go to great pains, this town council, to accommodate cyclists. I'm not against cyclists by any means. I am one myself occasionally. I certainly don't wear the high vis crap that the stupid Lycra and the dickhead helmets they have on their heads. I just go out in my normal everyday clothes, and that's it. I've actually got a video I'll probably put up of me doing a cycle ride. I'm too out of condition and too old for messing around with cycles, but occasionally I'll go out if the weather's not too bad. It is a good form of exercise, but I prefer to be in the dry and the warm. You can see a little, very narrow cycle lane. They've got white lined off to the left there. The yellow lines for you Americans are no parking at any time. You're not supposed to park or stop on those yellow lines. Our lane markings are quite different to yours over there, obviously, because we're a different country. There you go. They widened it out now. So you've got the cars can park right tight to the pavement on the left, or the sidewalk, as you guys call it. And there was a cyclist I just passed there in their own dedicated little cycle track, which is good. I mean, they probably feel safer now they've got these white lines to adhere to. A lot of them do, and a lot of them just cycle on the wrong side of that line, which they're technically quite entitled to do, but they're a bloody nuisance. I mean, the council goes out their way, and at great expense, makes these cycle lanes. But the cyclists don't all seem to want to use them, which is pretty annoying, actually. I mean, they're there for their safety and for their benefit. They should use the bloody things. In a moment, there's another cycle lane on t'other side of the road, and they've got this one that they've not got it coned off. They've actually installed little small bollards. The road's not that wide anyway. I can see somebody ploughing into those things one of these days. I think it's a step too far, personally. I think it's unnecessary, but this is what councils do. They tend to waste public money. It's not their money, so they don't care. Why would they care? They're answerable only to big government, right? There's some cones there, but now you will start seeing little small posts coming up. Where are they? They're down here a bit further. This is called Evening Hill, actually. You can see there's a post now. You can see the sandbanks from here. We're quite a few feet above it. I'm just dropping down Evening Hill now to the level. And this water on the right hand side is part of Poole Harbour. It's very shallow. You can walk right out, and it will probably not come up to your knees. And when it's closest to the wall, closest to the road, it's like ankle deep. It's ridiculous. But people do cockle picking. They go after cockles there, and there used to be, it used to be quite a good place for them at one time, but now the tourists have come down and they take anything. They take the tiny ones, they take all sizes. So of course the cockles are now in very short supply. They shouldn't be eating shellfish anyway. Biblically, we're not supposed to touch shellfish. But hey ho, that's me. I try and obey the laws, the biblical laws, as much as I can. The people that aren't into that or don't believe in the Almighty, they just go on doing what they've always done, which is fine until they've got to answer for it. I've got enough sins to answer for without that being added to it, so I don't touch anything shellfish wise. You can see the water there on the right hand side. It's a very low wall. You can jump over it. It's about, whoa, 5 feet down the other side, down to the water, so it's not a big drop. Easy to get down there. Of course, they've got all the parking spaces have all got damn meters on now, so they love screwing as much money out of people as they can, so they put parking meters everywhere. I've never paid when I parked up along here, and I never will either. If I see anything, I don't leave the vehicle for very long. If I see anything nasty about, I just hop back in, start the engine, and move off a few yards and then repark. I've never ever paid, and I don't intend to. Life's expensive enough as it is without being fleeced by bloody councils. And let's face it, what do they use the money for? They certainly don't spend it on the roads. They probably spend it on cycleways. And the cyclists don't pay anything to use the roads. And I'm not saying that they should. They haven't got engines. There's their own muscle power. So they're not classed as motor vehicles, obviously. So, yeah, No, I wouldn't. I'm not dead against cyclists at all. I'm kind of 50-50 on them. As I say, I do use a cycle myself occasionally. I do respect them if I pass them, especially on A roads and B roads out in the country. I'll always, when I can see, pass them. I'll always get right over to the other side of the road to give them a good clearance, as you're supposed to, actually. These properties on the left are very, very expensive. God knows why, because they're nothing to look at, but they've got terrific views. From the other side of those buildings, the sea is on the other side as well. That is open water the other side out to the channel. So this road is basically just a solid little spit of land that goes out to the chain ferry. It goes back round in a loop and comes back on this road. It's basically it's a no-through road. You can continue, but that means you've got to get on the chain ferry to do so. Either that, or you've got to come back in the loop and go back the way you've just come. But there's no roads apart from small side roads to the houses down this way. There's no actual through road to anywhere as such. Just coming up now to these ranks of shops down here, Rick Stein, this famous chef, has got a building there. That one just, I can't quite see it well enough on this editing suite, but it's in that rank of shops. That's where his restaurant is, Rick Stein. I shan't be dining there anytime soon, I don't suppose. Not that I want to. So we're on the ferry road now, going down towards Panorama Road. The road on the right takes you, it's got through, but all it is, it means it takes you round in a loop to where we come from. So we're coming up now to the end of the video, because down by the ferry I park up and then I do my little diatribe, which is number 25. I'm actually sat inside doing it live from there. It's not a recording. From home, I actually am sat in the vehicle doing it while I focus the camera on the outside rather than me. Much more interesting, much more photogenic. So we're just coming around now, swinging around to where the ferry queues normally start and the car park, which is where I'll go. There's a few little shops and a public toilet there that's probably closed as well. So there you can see the chain ferry, or at least you will in a moment. There it isn't, because there it is. That's it there. Well, if you watch the 25, or if you watched it, you'll see that thing going backwards and forwards as I do my little chat. My 25th chat, and this is where I actually park up now. So this, my friends, is the end of this video to Paul, and I'm so glad to have finished it. It was getting to be a real pain. I won't go into why it was a pain in the neck, but it was proven to be a real pain having to edit, go back to YouTube, wait for the upload, and it's so slow. I think I could do it faster on dial-up. It was ridiculous. I don't know why it's so slowed down. But there you are. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope to be posting some more before too long.